Here we have a type 2 superconductor sitting in a bath of liquid nitrogen. That means that this superconductor is at 77 Kelvin, or almost 200 degrees centigrade below the freezing point of water. This floating gold cylinder is an extremely powerful ferromagnet. The fact that it's floating is a phenomenon known as the Meissner effect. The Meissner effect is also known as perfect diamagnetism. This means that the superconductor allows no magnetic field lines to penetrate through its bulk. It does this by producing its own field lines, which make the superconductor a magnet, thus levitating the smaller magnet above it. Now we see our same gold magnet levitating above a type 2 superconductor, which allows a minimal amount of magnetic field lines to penetrate through its bulk. The superconductor will grab onto, or pin, these penetrating magnetic field lines, thus producing rigid levitations as we see. This next clip may give you an idea of just how strong this enhanced flux-pinning type 2 superconductor really is. Just watch how the magnet is snapped right back into its initial position by the superconductor. This is because of the flux line pinning. In order to change the orientation of the magnet above the superconductor, you must change the flux pinning within the superconductor. And in order to do that, you must apply force to the magnet and push the field lines through the bulk. Now, you may be wondering why our magnet is unable to move around on top of the superconductor, but as you can see, is free to rotate in one position. This is because the rotation of the magnet has no effect on the magnetic field strength felt by the superconductor, nor the direction in which the magnetic field lines penetrate through the bulk. In order to change the orientation of the magnet above the superconductor, one must apply a force. As you see here, we're applying just enough force with this little piece of paper to re-pin the flux lines within the superconductor and thus reorient the magnet in its levitations above the superconductor. Next, we will observe the most impressive result of enhanced flux pinning type 2 superconductors, that being magnetic suspension. But more on this later. Now we're going to switch the demonstration up on you a little bit. Instead of levitating a magnet above a superconductor, now we're levitating a superconductor above a magnet. The superconductor we see here is the same superconductor we were using earlier, but now wrapped in a few layers of insulation. The purpose of the insulation is to keep the superconductor within the superconducting phase without having it submerged in a bath of liquid nitrogen. If we didn't insulate the superconductor would warm up and surpass the critical temperature in under 10 seconds. Next, we'll see just how strong this enhanced flux pinning type 2 superconductor really is. You can shake it back and forth, and the superconductor just holds onto that magnet. You can even flip it over and shake it back and forth, and it still holds onto that magnet. It's pretty impressive if you ask me. Oh, and for you skeptics out there, that little piece of string isn't for tricks and fooling some foolish people. That's just a piece of fishing line I tied around the superconductor to dip it in and out of the liquid nitrogen without freezing my fingers off. Sorry to spoil your fun. Here we have our insulated superconductor now levitating back and forth above a magnetic track. The magnetic track is comprised of 23 bar magnets, 3 bar magnets wide and 7 bar magnets long, with 2 perpendicular magnets on either end, which act as brakes. The particular orientation of these magnets on the track work to confine the superconductor to the track while still allowing it to propagate back and forth. For more information on this, please refer to my paper listed at the end of this video. This close-up shot of one side of the track gives you a good idea of how the brakes work. Watch closely as the superconductor deflects when it passes over the brake region. Somewhat like a half pipe at a skate park, but not really. Now here's one of the cooler parts of this demonstration. As the superconductor is fixed to the track, you can actually pick the track up and flip it completely upside down, and the superconductor, as you would expect, just still hangs there. As long as you don't shake it around too much, the superconductor will stay on the track in any orientation you'd like to place it in. Now, this is the best part of the video. Watch this. Isn't that awesome? Look how the superconductor never touches the track. It is completely suspended by the magnetic fields the entire time. I feel that this track truly exemplifies the invariance of levitation and suspensions of type 2 superconductors in permanent magnetic fields.